In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to model this amazing, unique custom stair inside of Revit. And no, this isn't an in-place component. This is actually a line-based component family, which you can load into your project and adjust to your project. Let's go. Now quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about learning Revit, that's definitely the best place to be, with over 140 hours of content dedicated to interesting and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And first, I would like to kind of get started by explaining why are we doing this way. So when you have a unique custom stair like this, you're not going to be able to do it with the regular stair tool in Revit. Revit just wasn't built for this. So what you need to do is you need to do a custom job. So for that, you have two options. You have model in place, which would be you're just modeling in one project this stair, and you really can't use it in other projects. The approach that I'm going to be showing you now allows you to use that stair in future projects. However, it's not a perfect solution because you are going to have to modify it a little bit to your future project. So it's not like a complete solution, but it does give you kind of 90% of the job, and then you can just kind of make small adjustments and then use it again. And finally, when it comes to the component which we're going to be using, so it's going to be a line-based family with a two-step family loaded in, which can then be adjusted. So for this family, I'm not going to be showing you the entire process step by step. I think it's simple enough. You simply need to kind of take a look at the project where you're working at. You can use some detail lines just to sketch out the stair, just to get some basic measurements, and then you create this just simple generic family, which you can use as the two steps, which we can then use for the line-based family, which is something that I'm going to be showing you now. So here I have the completed two steps. And now let's start a line-based family where we're going to be loading this as a nested family. So for that, we need to go to the File menu, then we need to go to New Family. And here I'm just going to go one folder back so I can pick English metric. And then here I'm going to pick out the generic metric line based. So that's this one. You really want to pick the correct template for this. You hit open, and then once it opens up, this is what that's going to look like. So once we have this family, we can go back to our original two-step family and go to load into project. And now we can place it here. So I'm just going to hover over this beginning, hit the space key a few times until it's oriented correctly, and now I can click and place it. You can also go ahead here and lock it in place, so you can use the align tool, and then you can just lock it here to the beginning or the origin of this family. Okay, so once we have this in place, now we have to add some reference planes. So for that, let's go here to the Create tab and then go to Reference Plane. And I'm just going to come to the edge of this first step. So now we have that first step position. And now I'm just going to copy this to add additional steps. So let's go here to the copy tool, and then let's copy this once, twice, and then three times, just like that. Hit the escape key a couple of times. And now I'm going to navigate to the front elevation. So you want to go to the project browser, find the front elevation. And then here I want to add some additional reference planes in order to mark the position of the treads. So for that, let's go to the Create tab again, go to Reference Plane. And then I'm just going to come here, place one like that. So once I have one height placed, I can then just go to copy, and then I can copy this multiple times. I actually only want to copy it two additional times. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and now I have what's most important, and that's going to be this intersection here, marking where the next segment of these steps is going to be. So for the next step, what I'm going to do is select this stair, then I'm going to go to the array tool. So AR is the shortcut. And for this array, you want to make sure that this is a linear array. You want to make sure that group and associate is checked on. This is going to allow us to make this parametric. The number is going to be set to 2, and then move to is going to also be set to second. So now I'm just going to come here to this intersection, click, and then place it right here. And as you can see, now we have created that array. Now I'm just going to hit the escape key a couple of times. And now for that array, I want to turn this array into a parameter. So we go here to label and we go to add parameter. So first, of course, you have to select it. So you select one of the items, you select the array, and then you go to label, add parameter. And this is going to be the let's call it step count. We can let's set it to an instance parameter in case you have perhaps two different stairs in one project, and then we can just click OK. So once we have created this parameter, the next step is going to go back to the reference plane here and just check where this parameter is located at. So this is the length parameter. This is something that comes built in with these line-based families, and we just want to move it here. So we just want to move it to that reference plane at the end, basically marking kind of the edge of our step. So here, let's see. Did I do something wrong? No, everything seems to be okay. So once we have done this, now the next step is going to be to set up the formulas. So for the formulas, you want to go here to family types, open that up, and it's going to look like this. And now what we want to do is we want to make sure that our step count is basically the length of a couple of steps, the full length is our step count times the length of two steps. So for that, what we need to do is we just need to measure what two steps is. So let's go here to the measure tool, and then we can measure here, and that's 601.3 millimeters. So for that, let's go back now to family types, go here to the formula for the length, and then we can say here step count times, and then 601.3. So this is now going to lock everything together. So this is going to be working properly. We can then just hit OK. And now this family is ready. You also want to make sure to save it. So I'm just going to save it on my desktop as the test custom stair. Hit save. And now let's open up a project. So here we have a project. As you can see, I've been doing some testing here with the stairs and just the design and the dimensions. So here we want to now bring in that stair. So we can go back to this family. We can go to load into project and then pick out our sloped balcony design. Okay, so this is the project which I'm going to be using. And now this is a line-based family. So here I think we can just place it on the work plane like this. And then we should be able to just go like that. And there we go. We're placing the stair. Just go to the other reference plane, hit the escape key a couple of times, and now we have our stair in its place. Let's open up this section just so we can see it. Okay, and there we go. So actually, I think I should have placed it down on level 1. So let's just move it down. So I'm just going to go here to the move tool. And then I'm just going to move this stair down. And there we go. We now have this stair in place. Let's then open up level 1 and just see what this looks like in the 3D view. Open up a camera like that. And there we go. We have our really cool, let's try shaded or something. Yeah, we have our really cool stair here. And as you can see, you can create all sorts of custom stairs like this by using this approach. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you want to get access to all of these Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. There you can get access to all of my Revit project files, over 500 files so far. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.